This is called ling. This one is called perfume lemon. You can see that they have different shapes. And this one is yellow lemon. Actually, they have different fragrances, and this one is called lim. It's also an ingredient for the tea making. And this one is the passion fruit. Now we are going to make the second kind of tea, the joy in bitterness. For this tea, we also need to take 5 grams of tea leaves. Now it's 3:40. We've take 20 minutes to make the first kind of tea. And this is the jasmine tea leaves. Now, and you can say that this is the jasmine tea leaves. It's a kind of green tea. If you like, you can also use the jasmine black tea or the jasmine black liu bao tea. Such kind of tea leaves is a little bit old in our Chinese tea categories. But if you use other kind of tea leaves, it may be more suitable because it has the same kind of taste of the tea leaves, but also it has the aroma of flowers. Remember that for this tea soup, we also need to use the water with 85 degrees centigrade. Now we have add 200 milliliters of water into the cup. Now we also need to ensure the temperature is not that high. It should be around 85 degrees centigrade. And then pour the water into the teapot. You can, if the temperature is too high, you can also pour it slower, because in this process the temperature of the water is also lowered down. So this is also the Chinese wisdom. If you are interested, you can come here and make this tea with us. You can say that the tea soup and tea leaves in this tea cup, it looks beautiful. As time goes by, the tea leaves will, the aroma of and fragrance of the tea leaf will be released gradually. And the temperature is to make sure that the aroma can be released fully. So please remember that the temperature should be proper. And now we need to prepare the ingredients. Now we are removing the head and heart of the bitter melon. Now I'll have a try with this cup of tea. Oh, it's a little bit sour. And now, everyone, please remember to wear the glove. And the heart of the bitter melon should be removed. You can use your hand to remove the heart of the bitter melon. You can also use a scoop. Now we have removed the heart, the pulp of the bitter melon. If you don't want your tea to be too bitter, remember to remove the heart and the pulp of the bitter melon. If you want to know how bitter the bitter melon is, just imagine that in China, we also have some herbs that is also very bitter. So their flavor, their taste are similar. It's really bitter, so remember to remove it when you are preparing for these ingredients. This one is, I think this one have a very good balance of sourness and sweetness. For this one, as I've drink it, I think the sourness and sweetness are balanced, and I think it also have its own flavor and aroma. After you drink it, you can feel a kind of aroma, and also you can get the flavor of the citronella and the rosemary leaves. Now we are dicing the bitter melon. Now we are also going to measure the amount of bitter melon we need. Today we need 30 grams of bitter melon. Now we've got 30 grams of bitter melon. Now you can imagine the taste of this kind of tea because we used Peter and Alan. Now we can mash it with the modeler. If you prefer bitter taste, you can mash it for a longer time. But if you don't like the bitter taste, just mash it for several times. That is okay. Now we have mashed the bitter melon. Now I can smell the aroma of fruit and also the bitter aroma. Now the jasmine tea is already finished. So now we can pour the tea soup into another tea pot again. Now we've poured all the tea soup into the teapot, and the tea soup is prepared. Although it's called the green tea, actually the color of the tea soup is a little bit yellow. And this is the perfumed lemon. Now we need to take some ice cubes. We need about 200 milliliters of ice cubes, or 6 to 8 cubes. Now we put the ice cubes into the shaker. We need some time to ensure that the temperature of the tea soup is lower down. So now we need to add some ice cubes inside it. Now the temperature of the tea soup is quickly lower down than before. Now as we have added some ice cubes in the shaker, now we need to mash it again. Similarly, if you want to get the aroma of the bitter melon, you have to make sure that you mash the pulp of the bitter melon. But you also need to use the perfumed lemon to reduce the bitterness of the bitter melon. And now I can feel a combination about the freshness of vegetable and the fragrance of the fruits. Now we can use the stirring stick to speed up the melting speed of the ice. Now we can add in some mint leaves into the shaker. Just now, we've been mentioned that the fruits and vegetable and the tea need to meet a certain balance. So we need to ensure the coordination and the balance of our ingredients. And finally, we need to add the syrup or the sugar. You can add in 30 millimeter of syrup in it. For this kind of tea, we also can add in this kind of lemon drink in it. You can add 10 milliliters of lemonade in it. You can see that the lemonade looks a little bit green and it smells sour a bit. And for this joy in bitterness, it's better to make a cold drink because the bitterness of the bitter melon, so it's better that we use it to make an ice and cold drink. Now we need to take 200 milliliters of tea soup. Now pour it into the shaker. This one is also a kind of cold drink. The shaker method are usually used to make such kind of cold drink. Some students ask that how we can make the bitter melon not that bitter. Just as I've introduced, you can cut off the melon pulp in the heart of the bitter melon so that it won't be that bitter. Now we can shake the shaker again. You can see the way I'm shaking the shaker. It is aimed to fully mix the ingredients inside the shaker. You can see that it looks very fresh and green now. I can smell a kind of fresh smell. And I can also smell the aroma of the mint. And this is the ice cup. Now we are using the stirring stick to stir the ice. Just now I've mentioned I'm doing this to make the cup have a foggy effect. Now you can see that it looks foggy. Now